Hi everyone, today I'm going to discuss on the topic organization culture. What is organization culture? It means work culture. It is a set of values, beliefs and norms that are shared by an organization members, and everywhere the work culture is different depending upon the requirement of the organization. It is moreover, it is beneficial to the employees because it it brings a uniformity amongst the functions of the organization and it helps in better productivity and efficiency. Now let us discuss about the dimensions of organization culture. First of all, it sets a plan and policies for the organization. It sets a set of rules and regulations for the organization which will help in attaining the goals and priorities of the organization. Every organization is socially responsible to cater to the requirements of the society, and every organization should keep in mind that they should be doing something good for the society. The other thing is the competence and characters of the top management. The top management should have a good leadership quality which enhances in good decision making and good planning. Proper facilities and treatments has to be given to the employees so that they are staying in the organization, they stay committed to the organization and give better productivity and efficiency. The manager should adapt a good leadership style. It can be any form of style, but they have to see that whatever style has been implemented, they should get the best from the employees. Along with the motivation, we also have to see what kind of rewards and recognitions we are giving to the employees, because it really helps in boosting their morale and helping them to get the best from, and good employees will definitely stay if you are giving a good treatment to the to them. The other thing is the superior subordinate relation, which is very important, that there should be a cordial relation amongst superior and subordinate. For that, there should be an open communication between the two so that all the kind of expectations can be met, all the misunderstanding can be solved, and whatever problems happens due to communication gap, even that can be solved. As I said, that the communication system has to be strong, it has to be open, it has to be transparent, and definitely it has to be precise so that people have a good system of chain to work with. The other thing is every organization always have some problems like work conflicts, group conflicts. So that can be met if we have a positive approach towards in resolving the conflicts which happens in the organization. Now, how do we transmit this culture in the organization? There are various ways in which we can transmit this culture in the organization. The first thing is we can have a motivational stories where the manager can speak about successful stories of the organization so that the present or employees who are there working in the organization, they are motivated by those success stories and they can work better for their future prospects. Then there are certain rituals which every organization follows. For example, maybe a certain dress code which they follow, or maybe every month they have a meeting which is conducted to understand the happening of the organization. There can be some rituals where the superior always meet up their subordinate so that they understand the problems of the subordinate and try to resolve those matters. There are certain ceremonies which every organization conduct so that they can have a togetherness and a teamwork kind of effect can be brought amongst the employees, and there's a lot of cooperation and trust among the employees. The physical symbols of the organization also has to be taken care of, where we try to concentrate more on ergonomics, where we try to see that the workplace of the employees are much more comfortable to work. Maybe giving them a good office layout and a good cafeteria. All these things really play an important and vital role in the working of the organization. The last and the important thing is that language, the medium of language by which we try to communicate to the employees, because it's very important that whatever message we are passing to the employees has to be understood and it has to be properly implemented. For that, it is very necessary that we need to have a transparent and a understandable language which they understand. It can be any medium of language, English, Hindi, or any other regional language, wherever the office has been set up, so that the employees understand things better. And they can also, there is always a mode of communication which is much more easier for them to understand. So these are some of the ways by which we can transmit the culture amongst the employees very effectively. That's all. Thank you for today.